And welcome back to Homicidal All-Stars. I'm Joe Stern. Tonight, our challengers will find out if they've got what it takes to make it through the workplace safety nightmare known as the Industrial Zone. I hope you're ready for relentless action because this episode is guaranteed to keep you on the edge of your seat.
What the hell kind of place is this?
It used to be a forced labor facility, from what I heard.
Now, it's just a different kind of death trap.
Progress, right?
I need to ask you something. Hey! Red. I love your hair.
Thanks.
It would look so cute on me. What hair dye do you use? My hairdresser will know what to do.
Scarlet and Tybalt are thinking about visiting the local crematorium, but it looks like the entrance is password protected. That did something. I think they got the right button. Looks like they're beginning to see the pattern. That did the trick! The door to the crematorium is open, and with it, the opportunity to enter a bonus combat arena.
Oh, great. Another fight we could just skip.
Along with rewards that could give us an edge later on.
Nothing more cheerful than a visit to the local crematorium, especially with urns housing the remains of former contestants. But those ashes might come in handy if the challengers don't mind trading cover for breathable air. Scarlet's not taking any risks. Bringing out a drone. A jaw-dropping assault. Refusing to be rushed. More bullets, more fun. Oh, a lethal looking hit. Waste him! And Tybalt changes the bot's allegiance! Ready to rock after a quick heal. Trying to put itself back together. Catastrophic damage! Setting himself up for a shot. My goodness, what a hit! She can't be happy with that. Ooh, bam! Massive damage. Kill! With so many bodies, looks like the crematorium has had to open a new wing! Wait, what's this? The defenders are holding the mortician hostage? Do they really think that's gonna keep them from being mowed down by these seemingly unstoppable contestants? More defenders on the way! This crematorium is about to get a lot hotter! And she misses her target. Tybalt is the master of camouflage. Didn't miss that one. That's a game changer. Reloaded. Is not getting up. Oh. He just did the challengers a huge favor. Completely unhittable. quick reload, and he's good to go. No dice on that shot. Devastating! That gun's not gonna shoot! And the mortician is safe, and with plenty of job security to boot. She shoots him down! Waiting for a better shot. Shakalaka! Dead on target! Playing defensively for now. For some more bullets. Powerful! I can see his wounds closing! A solid hit! He finishes him off! Daring them to enter his range. He tops off his weapon, waiting for an opportunity. Switching to defense for a bit. Unable to hit the moving target. Catching some lead while on the run. Easy target. Challenge with this talented group of contestants making it through without a single casualty. After a close brush with death, our challengers are ready to search. The area for some more enemies to send to the crematorium. flame barrier and spike traps? Must be something valuable around there. And she gets herself another reward. Taking advantage of a well-placed station. That's it for the trap. The road to the final challenge of the episode is hidden behind this. There's a reward box waiting for the challenger who can figure out which tiles are safe to step on. Looks like she's got an idea. Shouldn't have stepped there. So far, so good. Found a safe spot. A mistake. Randomly choosing where to step is not the way to go. And she manages to claim a reward, as seen on TV. Healing up.
I'll need a key card.
Oh, that's a whole lot of spikes. Will that buy them enough time to get through? Applying some first aid.
Pretty cool in the past couple of episodes.
I'm glad to hear that.
I was kind of surprised when you didn't die in the first one, though. I hope you make it far!
Persistence pays off with another reward.